Welcome to GDs, and this is The Outpost, Season 2. Season starts with Captain Garrett catching up with Dredd, but he survives and Captain Garrett gets stabbed in the process. Meanwhile, back at the outpost, Janso has survived, and he is looking for a cure for the plaguelings, whereas the dragman has only given Talon one name, and wants her to summon it first. But as Talon summons the Lakiri, along with comes another Black Blood, who is in control of the Lakiri. And before she could call more of her friends, Talon closes the portal. And as Talon looks at her tattoos, she remembers that when she was young, one such Black Blood approached her and killed her entire human family, as he wanted Talon to pass on the power through which she controls the portal. But Talon was able to survive and killed him in the process. And the Black Blood, getting to know that Talon killed one of her kind, knocks Talon out and decides to take her power to open the portal, but learns that it could only be transferred willingly, and she takes the dragman with her and leaves. On the other hand, Princess Rosemary warned Marshall to find the traitor who helped Dredd escape, whereas Eleanor has learned how to farm Clipsum, and she is farming the same under the city. Talon, being conscious, follows the dragman, and the Black Blood confronts her. She lets her know that hundreds of her kind are stuck at the planet of ashes, and it was Talon's people who betrayed them in the fight against the human and trapped them in the planet of ashes. And she wants Talon to open the portal so they could bring back all their friends. Talon, not sure why her mother never brought everyone back, and learning that they despise humans and want to eliminate them, decides not to help her at the moment. Talon is not able to get to her as she is being protected by the Lakiri, and she wants Talon to pass her the power so she can open the portal and bring back every Black Blood, and gives Talon some time to think it over. Back at the outpost, a soldier from Garrett's patrol returns and informs them about his death. Princess Rosemary is broken, and Marshall decides to go and get his body, and he let Talon know that Dredd would have already made it to the capital, and now she needs to figure out a way to summon her demon army, as it's the only way they could defeat the Prime Order. Talon, seeing Princess Rosemary broken, as none of the noblemen or the governors in the region stands with her against the Prime Order, decides to give her power to Rafe in order to bring back all the Black Bloods. And as Talon was about to pass her power to Rafe, the dragman asks her not to, and she stops at the last moment and escapes with the dragman. While at the outpost, a new day brings a new ally. Nobleman Tobin wants to join Princess Rosemary's side, but in order to do so, he wants her to marry him so that he could have a royal legacy. But Princess Rosemary is not interested. But Tobin gives her 3 days to decide before he leaves. We also get to know that his advisor is the sister of Eleanor, and they have their own family rivalry. Princess Rosemary has given her help Naya the task of teaching Jinzo to woo Talon, but in the process of teaching Jinzo, they both fall in love with each other. On the other hand, Dredd has made his way to the capital and has Captain Garrett as his prisoner. But the Holy Three of the Prime Order, having some kind of mystical power, are upset with Dredd for his failure and use their power to torture him but spare his life for now. And they bring Garrett back to health with medicine as well as the power of the Holy Three. As Garrett recovers, they use trauma, manipulation, medicine and love to turn Garrett against Princess Rosemary by convincing him that she is the False Queen. And Garrett, being back in health, convinced that Princess Rosemary is the False Queen, pledge his loyalty towards the Holy Three. It is when his father shows up at the capital in order to rescue him, but being manipulated, and in order to prove his loyalty, he kills his own father. And the Holy Three, convinced of Garrett being in their control, send him to take care of Princess Rosemary and the Black Blood. Back at the outpost, the Dreadmen let Talon know that she could read Rafe's mind, and she is not the one to fulfill the prophecy, and gives Talon a key, which none of them know is for what. She also let Talon know that she will write all the names which she can hear from the Book of Names. On the other hand, Rafe goes to meet the Queen and lets her know that she could summon the entire demon army for her. But in order to do so, she wants the Queen to order Talon to give her the power to open the portal. And Rafe, in order to force Queen's hand, kills the dragman and all the name along with it. But the dragman was able to keep one name safe. The Queen rejects her offer and lets Talon know everything. Rev, exhausting all her options, takes Queen hostage with the help of her Lakiri. And in exchange for her life, she wants Telin to give her her powers. Telin, seeing no option, decides to summon the last name which the dragman left. And with the Lakiri came a black blood named Zed. And he let Telin know that in the plane of ashes, there are two groups of black bloods. One like Rave, who don't think they can coexist with human, while others like him, who believe they can coexist with humans. And they are constantly at war with each other. And in order to win Telin's trust, Zed gives the control of his Lakiri to Telin. And Telin goes to Rave, and she is able to rescue the princess and kill Rave and her Lakiri in the process with help of Zed and his Lakiri Vic. But Princess Rosamund, on seeing the demons so up close and personal, is quite afraid of them and does not want Telin to bring any more and ask her to send both of them back. Princess Rosamund has other problems as well. Being free from Prime Order, they don't want to use labor to work in the mines. And having no money in the treasury, she is not able to provide salary to the people to work in the mines. Eleanor, seeing this as an opportunity, and in order to prove her superiority towards her sister, decides to bankroll the queen. In exchange, she wants the queen to appoint her as her advisor. The queen agrees and lets her know that she cannot be involved in any illegal activity. While Tobin, completing 3 days and the queen still not agreeing to marry him, decides to leave. But his advisor wants him to try a different approach. She wants Tobin to quit drinking, have a humble approach, and pledge his loyalty towards the queen without any conditions. The people at the outpost are worried as the Lakiri has been killing animals to survive, and they think it might be them next. Princess Rosamund already asked Telin to send them back, and knowing that they are still present, Princess Rosamund and Telin are at odds with each other, and Telin strikes a bargain with Queen and lets her know that she wants to know more about her people, and in order to do so, she wants Zed to stay but will send Vic back, and the Queen allows her request. Zed is not happy with the decision but agrees with Telin to send Vic back for now. Zed lets Telin know that the key the dragman gave her unlocks great power, and they set out from the outpost in order to look for the missing piece of the key. Telin lets Zed know that the queen might provide their kind a place to stay in the kingdom once they defeat the Prime Order. But Zed does not trust the queen and is also not sure where Telin's loyalties lie, with her kind or the queen. And as they look for the missing piece, Telin and Zed make up. Back at the outpost, seeing the humble side of Tobin, Princess Rosamund starts to fall for him. Princess Rosamund, in order to increase their army size and to attract other nobles to join them, decides to partner up with one of Tobin's cousins, and she offers him Tobin's land if he decides to join them, as Tobin won't be needing them since she will be marrying Tobin. And as they get ready for the marriage, Tobin is able to figure out that Naya is the traitor, and Princess Rosamund gets her arrested. Genzo, being in love with her and knowing she did it because Dredd had her family captured, helps her escape the prison. But as Genzo is helping to find a cure for the plagueling and has already cured two, Princess Rosamund doesn't imprison him for now. Garrett finds Telin on his way to the outpost and he stabs her, and Telin, in order to survive, jumps to the planet of ashes, and when she returns, she decides to go back to the outpost to warn the queen. Zed is not happy for the same, as he thinks Telin's loyalty lies more towards the queen than his own kind. Garrett reaches the outpost and takes the princess away before she could marry Tobin. By the time Telin reached, the queen was already gone, and Telin decides to go after him, and Tobin joins in with her, and they are able to rescue the queen and capture Garrett. But in the process, Tobin is injured, and as Tobin was not able to marry the princess, the deal they stuck with their cousin is off and he leaves the outpost. And Telin sets off with Zed again to know what the key opens. As they assemble the key and reach the temple where the key could be used, it brings out 7 containers, but all of them are broken except one. And when they look into it, Zed gets some kind of a power similar to that of Telin and the Holy Three. Zed let Telin know that there are 7 Kling, each with a different power, and he is not sure what his could do yet. Back at the outpost, Genzo stops Garrett from taking the medicine provided by the Prime Order. He escapes that night and tries to kill the queen. Being off his mid, he is able to see things clearly. and realizes that he has been manipulated and comes back to his senses. Further at the outpost, Tobin sends away his army to protect his land when his cousin left. But it turned out it was just a ruse for them to lose their strength, and now his cousin has laid a siege at the outpost. In order to end the siege, they come up with a plan and decide to let loose plaguelings from Eleanor's farm, as Eleanor confesses to the queen that all the enemy soldiers have been taken clipsum provided by her, and they are able to end the siege, and Princess Rosamund arrests Eleanor for being involved in production of clipsum, and Genso is able to come up with a cure for the plaguelings. And as he cures everyone, Princess Rosamund also sends him to the prison for letting Naya loose, while Geralt decides to go back to the capital and take care of those who manipulated him. Meanwhile, Telen learns that Zed knew about his power and he can control people's mind. And as he tried to use it on Telen to bring back more of the Black Bloods, he fails since it does not work on people with power. And Telen, not trusting him, sends him back to the planet of ashes. But Telen is captured by the Prime Order soldier. Naya has also reached the capital, and as she goes to meet Dredd, she learns her family has been killed long before, and she avenges their death by killing Dredd. And as Naya makes her way out of the capital, she sees a weapon being taken by the Prime Order soldiers towards the outpost. On his way to the capital, Geralt saves Telen, and as they reach the capital, they find that the Prime Order soldiers have already left for the outpost, but Geralt is able to take care of one of his captors. As Geralt and Telen return, they find the camp of Prime Order's soldier, and Telen decides to take care of one of the Holy Three, as she sees him using his power, but he survives long enough in order to transfer. Back at the outpost, a boy approaches Princess Rosamund, claiming to be his brother, and as Princess Rosamund investigates his claim, it turned out he was indeed his brother's best friend, and Princess Rosamund imprisons him for lying to her. At the same time, Naya also returns to the outpost and let the princess know about the weapon. She is thankful to her but also imprisons her for her betrayal. In the prison, Eleanor, learning about Naya, let Genso and Naya know that they are brother and sister, while Geralt and Telen also reach the outpost and let everyone know that the Prime Order army is coming. Princess Rosamund, seeing she lost her way, decides to free all her friends as they prepare for the war to come. And as the Prime Order attack, they are able to defend from the first wave. But in the process, Eleanor died. They have also come up with a plan to go behind enemy lines and use their own weapon against them, and Genso and Geralt takes care of the same. But more soldiers have joined the Prime Order's army, and the outpost has already lost the game. So they fall back to the keep to make their last stand. And Telen, knowing it to be the end, decides to summon Zed and ask him to start calling out names. And Zed calls out all the Black Bloods from the portal. And as the fight continues, Geralt is able to reach their camp. And he learns that the power has already been sent back to the capital, and Geralt detonates their own weapon. And the outpost, with the help of Black Blood army and Geralt using their own weapon, are able to defeat the Prime Order for now. As the season ends, Princess Rosamund decides to welcome Black Bloods to the outpost, but Zed lets her know that it will be the other way around, as the outpost is now theirs and all of them are their prisoners. And he wants Telen to decide who she stands with, the humans or the Black Bloods.
Thanks for watching, and if you liked it, please subscribe.